welcome back. This is episode 2. We are with the spiders, and things are not going too well. Captains are picking teams. Not that it matters, because I will not be on them. Okay. Ow! These spiders are cheating, is what's happening. Okay. I think that's all of them. Okay. Let's get out of here. Please. I don't like it here. That's fine. Shears don't work. But now we know for sure that shears don't work. Oh, I didn't mean to throw out the... You're taking a long time to die, sir. Hello? Yeah, we're just going to mine these. Sorry if this is boring, but this is a necessity. No one's going to kill me this early on. Not with the game modes at hand. So I just need to take this time to regroup and assess my mistakes. Of which there are many. Why is that birch? What is this game? Come on. Okay. Oh, because those are birch leaves. What is up with the trees in this game? Okay, any bit I missed of wood? No. Okay, cutting down these trees is a pain. Those ones, especially like this. I don't know, what the fuck are these trees doing? I have 2 apples. I would like more. But we only have this little scrabble to work with. 3 would be fine. I'd really like more than that, too. But I'm not going to get greedy. Because I'm in no place to get greedy right now. Yeah, I'm still going to go with my original picks of I want either Mr. Cute or Normo. Even though I don't know who Smooth Maneuver is. Oof. Mega oof. Is that Brink? I don't know. We'll figure it out. I don't even know. No, Brink's not even in the round, is he? No, he's not. Huh. Come on. Another apple. Please. I'm a desperate boy. We're not getting another apple. It's just not gonna happen. I'm gonna keep the damn sapling. This is what it's come to. Okay. Onwards and outwards. To an actual cave. And damn, maybe more food too. This is rough. City World's rough. I may sound like a broken record, but for as many City World games as I played, it is still probably my least favorite RR game mode. Among the popular ones, that is. Among the popular ones. I'm sure there are other random ones that I would just despise, but... You know, City World, not a fan favorite, if I'm the fan. Okay, now I don't need this sapling, I'll just... I don't want to, like, fuck myself over and then rely on my teammates, but, that may be what goes down. There's a big hole there, of no interest to me. Maybe more melons, or potatoes at least, or just flowers. Yep. This is great. Really cool. Epic. Yeah, maybe there is. We're gonna try it. We're gonna try, actually, we're just gonna go down here under the tree, so we're a little more safe, or at least have the illusion of safety. Something, hopefully, is down here. Ah, something. Let's move along with the questions. If I could only eat one type of food for the rest of my life, what would it be? So it'll have to be something that just naturally lends itself to variety. So I'm gonna say salad. Because you can have lots of different kinds of salad. You can have fruit salad. You can have a garden salad. You can even, like, make an argument that poke is a salad, right? Or sashimi. Raw fish salad. So you can have savory salads. You can have sweet salads. Right? If you're saying type of food, I'm going to go with salad. Because it's just... Those are just mixed ingredients. The barrier to entry for a food item to be called a salad is minimal, for sure. So that would be my answer. I know it's kind of a cop-out answer. I know for both of the questions thus far. I've given answers that can be seen as cop-out answers, but, you know, if someone, like, actually asked me that, then that's what I would say. So I'm not going to deprive you of my truth. I'm going to tell you what I would say. I would eat salad for the rest of my life. And now I'm full iron. Would you look at that? Okay. More questions. Tell me your darkest secret, and also the last time you felt truly alive in this deep, dark world. Well, this is kind of a two-parter, and none of them are questions, but more so demands. But I respond to anything, I'll respond to demands. So, my darkest secret. Good question. Right, thank you for your involvement. I'd say my darkest secret. Here's something that's been weighing on my mind for a while. When I was in kindergarten, I went to a school. It wasn't a very big school, but it was... that's not what I meant to say. It was a pretty big school for the town. Because where I lived when I was in kindergarten, there were not a lot of people, but we were contained enough that we only really had one set of schools, so our school sizes were probably more than normal. Now, my kindergarten classroom probably had over 20 kids in it, which for, I don't know, 2003 or whenever I was in kindergarten, 2003, I think, 2004 maybe? No, 2003. Whenever I was in kindergarten, I think 2003, there were a lot of people there. Like, it was a class of, I don't know, we had two classes, I think they each probably had like 30 kids in it. So it was significantly sized, just because the district decided to only put one school in each district. What am I saying? Oh, I am a little tipsy. The school size was above average, even though the population of our island was not very condensed at all. Definitely not worth that many. There are still. I'm gonna keep mining down. Oh. What? Is that what I just mined? Or is this like a new thing? It is what I just mined. Those could be the air blocks I was finding. Damn it. So if I go over here. Wow, I got distracted again. So, actually, the class size doesn't even matter for what I'm about to say. Basically, there was this girl. And she had a total crush on me. All right. She had a total crush on me, and I had a crush on her, but because I was a sleazy little kindergartner, she wasn't the only girl I had a crush on, right? I had a crush on this other girl, too. Snowman Brant was slain by Mr. Q. Why? Why would you kill a solo? So the girl that liked me, and I liked back, her name was... Oh, we should change her name. Her name was Sylvia. I know she watches my videos, obviously. Her name was Sylvia. Right, so we both liked each other. I obviously I didn't know that she liked me, but, and obviously it's kindergarten, so take everything with a grain of salt. I don't know if we actually really liked each other, but you know, I thought she was pretty cute. I wanted to give her, you know, a big old hug. So Sylvia and I liked each other. Now this other girl, Linda. I like Linda a lot, but Linda did not like me, and I kind of knew Linda didn't like me. I had my suspicions for a while, because I wasn't smooth with Linda, right? I kind of let it show a little bit, you know, as kindergartners let their emotions show maybe a little too much. That was me. So Linda caught on. Linda's like, okay, so El Gavino Supremo, this guy digs me. So I'm gonna milk this. That's what she said. This is what this kindergartner, this she said. She said, I'm gonna milk this scenario. I know that he likes me. I'm not gonna tell him if I like him or not. He's going to have to guess, and then 20 years later, he's going to have to tell someone about it while he's playing a game of Minecraft. And to that day, he won't even know if I actually liked him or not, because I'm just that bitch. It's like, okay, Linda, you know, whatever you want. But not really, right? Like, to this day, I'm fucking pissed at, like, Linda, if you're watching it, like, fuck you. No, no, I'm going to use your real name, Lexi. Her name was Lexi. It was... don't remember her last name, but it was Lexi. So, like, fuck Lexi. Anyway, Sylvia, though, she cute. And Lexi was cute too. I'm not going to talk about her in retrospect as being cute, because that's gross. But at the time, I'm like, okay, Lexi, you know, okay, Sylvia. Like, I could work with either of you, but it's going to be more fun to work with Lexi. Because it's kind of that chase thing. Because what happened was Sylvia's best friend told me that Sylvia liked me. All of a sudden, my interest in Sylvia went down, like, a lot. Because you don't want... Right? That's no fun if you like each other. No one wants that to happen. So, you know, you want that chase. You want that crazy adrenaline that only love can cause. So that's what I was pursuing. So I'm like, ah, Sylvia, come on. No. Drop it. Drop it, Sylvia. This isn't going to work between us. That was what was going on in my head. I didn't say any of this or act on any of this. Let me tell you what I actually did. So, we were learning the alphabet, which was rather elementary, even for something before elementary school. I was quite the advanced learner. Is it easy mode? It is easy mode. It definitely is. Yeah. What a game. I'm this low on health in easy mode. Oh, there's just no poison. No, it's still easy mode, I think. Anyway, none of this matters. I didn't smell that, though. That matters, but smell it. It's important to me, at least. We're also gonna... So anyway, Sylvia, we are learning the alphabet, and one of the things that we learn is that Q and U always have to go together. It's almost like they're married. No, they're off. Yeah, what the fuck? So, our kindergarten teacher, to celebrate this, decided that we should all get married. And I went up. And we got to choose who we got married to. Very, very sick. Very perverted. So what happens is one of Sylvia's friends is like, Gavin, El Gavino Supremo. Oh, find out what she said next time.